Hello, and today we want to show you how to pull the pump on the Arzel panel so you can test it and get a baseline. This is going to be with our metal enclosure, and we'll do another video for the newer PVC enclosure that we're offering. So to remove the pump from the panel and get the baseline, first thing you need to do is remove these two front support pillars. There's a Phillips head screw from the bottom of the panel holding them in place. Once those are out, it's a taper fit. You're going to take your screwdriver, slide the tubing off the back of the pump. And then you're going to pull the pump off the back support legs, and you can remove it from the edge of the control board. Now when you're testing the pump, the back side of the pump's the side with the two red wires. To test the vacuum, we're going to connect to the blue port there on the back right hand side of the pump. Make sure our manometer's on, and then we're going to turn the MPS switch on, plugging the pressure port, the back left, with our finger. With the manometer on, we can see that we have negative 50 inches, right around there. At a minimum, we're looking for negative 35 inches. If we can achieve negative 35 inches, we know the pump is working correctly. So in this case, we're at negative 48.5. That is a good pump. So now we're going to check the vent pressure side of the pump. Just move our manometer hose to the back left-hand port, plug the blue port on the back right with our thumb. We're looking for at least positive 40 inches of water column on the pump right there. I can see that we have 70 inches, so I know that our pump at testing at 70 inches on the positive side, 48 inches on the vacuum side, is a good pump. That's our baseline, and that's what we're going to work with when we go to test the dampers and the solenoids.